I'm able to eat this because India has a decent value chain system and a decent transport system when it comes to its vegetables and fruits. This apple, by the way, is 10 days old, but it's not enough. A lot of our vegetables, a lot of our food grains, a lot of our perishable food products get lost in transport and do not reach the consumer. In fact, it's as high as 35%. What are the reasons behind it and how can we resolve it? Hi guys, my name is Anu Jindal and today we are going to talk about the third part of our discussion on doubling farmers' income. We have already talked about two aspects in our analysis on Niti Aayog's report. The first one was modernizing agriculture and the second one was policy and governance, which means that what are the ways in which we can modernize our agriculture and what are the ways in which we can change our policies and governance in order to improve it. With the objective of what? With the objective of doubling farmers' income by 2022. Today, let's talk about the third aspect, that is value chain and rural infrastructure. So this is the third part of doubling farmers' income analysis by Niti Aayog report. So let's move on to the PPT, wherein we'll be talking about the third aspect of doubling farmers' income. As you can see here, there are three main objectives that have been pointed out by Niti Aayog for doubling farmers' income. These are number one, creation of modern rural infrastructure and an integrated value chain system. What does it mean? Modern rural infrastructure means infrastructure for farming. Modern rural infrastructure means infrastructure for farming, which includes provision for electricity, provision for roads, rural roads, provision for better transport, which includes cold storages, and provision for ability to sell directly to the consumer through offline or online platforms. So all these form a part of rural infrastructure. Okay, so infrastructure for farming plus infrastructure for adding value. Infrastructure for adding value. This can be done by fruit processing. So what we need is, let's say, this is the fruit that you have. This has been produced by a particular farmer and now he wants to transport it. So what all things do he need? Does he need? He needs better roads. He needs good transport systems, which includes the cold storages. He needs the ability to sell wherever he wants, in whatever way he wants. And he needs the ability to either process it himself or to transport or sell it to someone who can process it for this particular farmer. Let's say he wants to create jam out of this apple, or he wants to create, there are technologies which are creating honey out of apples rather than creating honey out of honeybee. Okay, so these are the ways in which value chain can be enhanced, rural infrastructure can be improved. So the first objective is very clear. You create modern rural infrastructure and you create an integrated value chain system so that we can also export it to a lot of countries around the world. What is the second objective? Boost India's exports of food products. Now, this is the second one and connected with the first one. When you have an integrated value chain system, when you have good rural infrastructure, then you can export more of your food products. And what is the advantage? The advantage of everything that we are going to discuss is going to be connected with doubling farmers' income. So here the advantage is better price in exports, because if you're exporting your food products outside, you're supposed or you're expected to get better price in exports, and that means more income for farmers. And the third one is more occupational diversification, which means you provide more quality employment opportunities, mixed farming, multiple farming, all those things become or make a part of your doubling farmers' income objectives. Now, what is the current situation? We've understood what Niti Aayog wants to achieve and through what ways does it want to achieve its objectives. But there is a current situation which is good at times and bad at times. In some aspects, it is good. In some aspects, in some other aspects, it is bad. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, the objective is one of the rural infrastructure. Gram Sadak or road is one of the part of rural infrastructure. Although this particular Yojana has been on for a long time, has contributed a lot, but a lot needs to be done. There are a lot of areas where farmers are not able to transport their produce in the stipulated time, and that's why a lot of their produce gets lost, gets destroyed in transport, because they don't have roads, as basic thing as road. Saubhagya scheme, the purpose of Saubhagya is household electricity. Now what you know, the Niti Aayog wants to achieve is that the you know, household electricity in rural areas should be differentiated or separated from consumption of electricity for farming, so that number one, you know how much consumption is required, number two, the electricity supply for farming is you know, a more high-tech supply, and at the same time a seamless supply without any breaks, because if a farmer is not able to access electricity on a regular basis during farming period, then a lot he incurs a lot of losses. So Saubhagya scheme, household electricity, current situation, future, as per Niti Aayog, they should be separate. Recommendations of Dalwai committee, which was set up for the purpose of doubling farmers' income. When the recommendations are out, then they'll be important. Electronic National Agriculture Market, ENAM. What is the purpose? The purpose is to create a unified national market so that everybody, all the farmers and consumers, can come together and they can sell and buy stuff online itself. They don't have to go through intermediaries. The farmer gets a lot of income, additional income. The consumer pays less inflation, at the same time more income for both the parties. Massive post-harvest losses, the estimate is 92,561 crores. So this is important, post-harvest losses, the estimate. And what is the main reason? Due to lack of cold storages. That is the main reason behind these post-harvest losses that I've already explained through the example of apple. Most existing cold storages are single commodity storages. So that is another major problem, because these cold storages do exist, but they're segregated, number one. And number two, they are single commodity exchanges. Okay, so that's a major problem. Sampada scheme. The scheme is focused on decreasing agriculture waste and modernizing processing activities. That is, focus is on agriculture processing. If agriculture processing is high tech, agriculture waste automatically goes down. So of course, Sampada scheme is in the right direction. That is what Niti Aayog also says. And last, we have Operation Green. The purpose, major purpose of Operation Green is promoting farmer producer organizations, which are similar to what happened in Operation Flood and what resulted in the success of Operation Flood. Basically, community led organizations, which are also called as farmer producer organizations for farming, which can come together and create more value for every farmer, because they are like a community coming together, producing together or selling together under a big brand. Okay, so these are the main areas pertaining to current situation. What are the constraints and what is the way forward when it comes to rural infrastructure and value chain analysis? Okay, public and private investments are low. You need to increase the public and private investment in agri processing, value chain creation, and marketing. Inability to acquire land for food processing and also for creating warehouses, things like warehouses, cold storages, ripening chambers, so on and so forth. Existing market infrastructure are suffering from lack of finance, manpower and proper facilities. Why? Because the private sector does not want to get into agriculture. The reason being that it is heavily controlled by the government. When it is heavily regulated or controlled by the government, there is high corruption, at the same time less opportunities for the private sector, and therefore the private sector shies away from entering it, and that automatically results in lack of finances, lack of manpower, lack of proper facilities, and therefore you know, more obsolete methods of farming. Poor maintenance of rural roads, a part of Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, lack of traceability mechanism, not very important. Way forward. So what should be done in order to counter or overcome these constraints, flows directly from these constraints? Number one, we should be giving infrastructure status to agriculture value chains. Now, value chains include warehouses, cold storages, ripening chambers, and a lot more. But these are the major examples to help you understand what is a value chain. what Niti Aayog suggests is that agriculture value chains should be given infrastructure status. When they are given infrastructure status, then they can easily generate funds from infrastructure financing companies. And when they can do that, they can create this infrastructure at a faster pace, resulting in more infra for farming, resulting in more income for farmers, resulting in, because the stability as well as the availability of better infrastructure is going to be more. Agriculture markets at the Grameen level, production and processing has to be linked, because let's say I have this apple and there is no facility to either store this apple in the cold storage, or let's say to convert it into something like jam or let's say honey. Now, if that is not available, a lot of these apples are going to go waste, are going to rot in the future. And therefore, it is directly a loss to the farmer. So when we link production and processing together, then we are overcoming that loss. Okay. Food processing through agripreneurs. So this is what Niti Aayog report has suggested, that agripreneurs should be encouraged. That means private sector. Okay, because agripreneurs is entrepreneurs in the private sector. Who are these entrepreneurs? Entrepreneurs are people like you and me who are willing to go out there and create something in agriculture in order to earn a better income, in order to at the same time do something better for the society in terms of creating better farming facilities. Now, this is very important for RBI warehouse upgradation. Niti Aayog says that there should be negotiable warehouse receipts should be allowed, called as ENWR, and because this is talking about direct trading of what is there in the warehouse through warehouse receipts, which will result in better financial opportunities for agripreneurs. Because let's say I'm an agripreneur, I decide that, okay, let me create a warehouse. I will be earning some income out of renting that warehouse to some farmer. And when the farmer comes and stores certain food product in that warehouse, I can also trade on that food product through a warehouse receipt trading, and I can share the income with the farmer. So the farmer is also getting more income out of that trading through warehouse receipts. At the same time, I am also getting some income. Okay. Convergence in government initiatives, maintenance of rural roads through women self-help groups. This is something new that Niti Aayog has provided. It has already been a success in Uttarakhand, explored, experimented in Uttarakhand, and has become a success. Incentivize private investment in farm implements. Mahindra and Mahindra is already doing a great job in this through its trucks and through various other implements. Export-oriented clusters, just like SEZ, should be created only for farming as well, which have all that required infrastructure, whether it's roads, whether it's electricity, whether it's water, whether it's value chain systems, cold storages, all those things need to be there. Increase the number of testing laboratories, and all the other reasons are not very important ones. Okay, so assume that you're going to a market, a big supermarket like, let's say, Reliance or let's say Spencer's or something like that. And what you see out there is that all those food products, whether it's apples, whether it's brinjal, whether it's anything else, everything is available under one roof. Now, how are they able to provide that under one roof? Through cold storages and availability of infrastructure. Reliance puts that infrastructure in play, gathers all that food stuff which is perishable, puts that in the cold storages, and it's available on the shelf for a longer period. That's why a lot of people don't want to go to these supermarkets for buying vegetables and fruits, because they think that it's put in cold storage, it's an old one, the nutrition value is less, but at the same time it's better than getting rot. Like, so a lot of, you go to a normal mandi which is there on the roadside, you see, rotting vegetables everywhere. So it's better than that. You're providing that food to people rather than allowing it to rot on the floor or on the roads. So that is the entire, that is the way you can imagine it, you can visualize it, and you can remember it. Which of the following is incorrect? So let's take some questions based on whatever we have done till now. We've done a lot. I think this is our fifth or sixth video, and a last part of drivers on farming. Post that, we will move into certain other drivers. So the first question to whatever we have done till now is, which of the following is incorrect with respect to the report strategy for New India at 75? You have to find out the incorrect one. The report has been released by Niti Aayog. Very easy, of course, correct. The report defines clear objectives for 2022-23. Now, The examiner can play with this date, but it's correct. It is detailed exposition across 75 crucial areas. Does it provide 75 crucial areas? What is the meaning of 75? It is 75 years of independence and not 75 crucial areas. So therefore this is incorrect. Raise the economy's size in real terms from US$2.7 trillion in 2017 to US$4 trillion by 2022-23. These facts are important. This question I can surely say can be asked as it is as well, this particular statement. Accelerate the GDP growth rate to achieve target of about 8% during 18 to 23, that is 5 years period. This is also correct. So all these are important statements which can actually be put forward and asked to you in the examination, and the correct answer here is C, because this is the incorrect statement. So I hope you have understood this. If you're unable to recall, if you have not understood what I'm talking about in this question, go back and watch all those 4-5 videos of Niti Aayog that I've already put forward. Okay, so make sure that you watch all those videos, because they will help you understand a lot of economic and social issues, current as well as basics. Let's come to the second question. Which of the following is not the category under the report Strategy for New India at 75? Not the category. There are four categories: drivers, infrastructure, inclusion, and governance. This I mentioned in my first intro video on Niti Aayog India at 75. Therefore, the answer is socialism. Even if you don't know this, I think you can very well understand that drivers is a generic term. Infrastructure, very important for our economy. Everybody has been saying that has to be a part. Inclusion, whether it's financial or social, has also been an important point of debate. Governance also has been an important point of debate and discussion, even by the Prime Minister. Therefore, these things have to be a part of our, report by Niti Aayog, which is a vision document. But socialism is an old concept. It was there during the Cold War era. It has been since been negated, neglected, and rejected, and therefore need not be a part of it. Let's come to the third question. Choose the correct statement. So we have to find out the correct statement out of these five. Exports of goods and services combined should be increased to US$800 billion by 2022-23. If you have not gone through this, or if you don't remember this data, I would recommend that you go back to the previous videos and watch this. So this also gives you an idea, okay, what are the different kinds of data and facts which are important for the examination. A strong push to zero budget natural farming. You need to understand the meaning also, which I had explained in the previous videos. Techniques that reduce cost, improve land quality, and increase farmers' incomes. This is certainly a right correct statement. Replacing APMC with APLM Act. I had explained this, I remember. Correct. Consider replacing the CACP by an agriculture tribunal in line with provisions of Article 323B of the Constitution. This is also correct, but you need to remember these keywords that I am highlighting: CACP, agriculture tribunal, Article 323B of the Constitution. So the answer is E. All of the above, all the statements are correct. If you have not gone through, or if you don't remember these facts, please go back to the previous videos and watch them again. Very important facts. Fourth question, which of the following is not the driver as per the report? Total of 11 drivers had been provided. I'd explained all those 11 in my first intro video. Industry, yes. Technology and innovation, yes. Modernizing agriculture, yes. Policy and governance, yes. So the answer is again E, none of the above. All of them are drivers as per the report. The last question is, which of the following committee has been established to prepare report on doubling farmers' income by 2022? I had explained this and mentioned this in this particular video itself, and the answer is Ashok Dalwai Committee. A very easy question. Please keep it in mind, the recommendations of this committee also hold importance. So as and when they come out, it's important that you cover them as well. Questions can be answered in this question can be asked in this way also. So this was the video on doubling farmers' income, last part, third part, that was value chain and rural infrastructure, and a total of 5 questions based upon whatever we have done till now with respect to Niti Aayog report. I hope you've understood and you like this video. In the future, I'll be creating and I'll be covering all the drivers one by one and moving towards infrastructure, inclusion, governance, and all the aspects of the report one by one. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon, because that way you don't miss out any video. You think it's not important? It is very important. All the very best. Take care.